Hi, the SACD is rather unique format, which has remained relatively unknown. Developed by Sony and Philips, it was expected to replace the CDDA. It was a better quality, improved audio disc format, but in the end, it went on other paths. All through, the prototypes were ready by 1997. It was introduced in 1999, and shortly after, it was launched onto the Japanese market, and then to the US market. The first Sony SCD-1 player cost ¥500,000, in the US it was $5,000. Stereo only, and CD and SACD playback were only possible. Alongside with a standard RCA output, it had SPDIF optical output for the Japanese market, also included XLR output. The sound quality was really impressive. I couldn't find any information about the first SACD discs, but that known for example Miles Davis's Kind of Blue, also classical albums were released around May of 1999. Hybrid SACD was released in 2002. This disc contained a CD layer and a SACD layer, which are generally simply called the HD layer. The advantage was they can be played back on any general CD player. The first Hungarian SACD was released in 2004. Zoltán Kocsis conducts Hungarian National Philharmonic Orchestra plays a selection of Béla Bartók. Released by Hungaroton, and the hybrid disc contains 5.1 surround sound on the HD layer. So, how does it work? That isn't that simple, as Sony doesn't like to publish their secrets. So I couldn't find any detailed explanation. A CDDA disc contains 44.1 kHz, 16-bit PCM, pulse code modulated audio. More about the CDDA in the video linked here. The SACD works in completely different way. In fact, every single element is different. It also totally incompatible with other existing formats. It uses the 4.7 GB disc basically, that was marketed in 1996 in Japan, called DVD, and its wavelength 650 nanometer. So the SACD contains a special bitstream called Direct Stream Digital. Sony has been developing this since 1990 in a 1-bit quantization up to 6 audio channels for approximately 110 minutes can be stored in a single layer. But it uses extremely high sampling rates that corrects the 1-bit limitations. If that is true, the values of this 1-bit, when 0, the voltage is lower than the previous sample was, when 1, then it's higher. I couldn't find any explanation how the sample will describe the signal exactly. The sampling rates are generally 2,822,400 Hz per second. So this many samples will be taken from the music in 1 second. This is 64 times 44.1 kHz compared to the CD sampling rates. So 64 times higher. So it's called DSD64. This DSD64 is the basic version. Most of the SACD uses this. DSD128 is rarely on SACD, which is 128 times CD quality. 128 times 44.1 kHz, approximately 5.6 MHz, nearly 5.7 millions of samples per second, just to give you an idea about its speed. But if this is not enough, the DSD256, 11,289,600 samples in a second, that is 44.1, 256 times. But this version has 48 kHz based version as well, with 12,200,000 288,000 sampling rate. DSD 512, 22,579,200 samples, which is a CD 512 times, or 24,576,000 samples for 48 kHz based. And finally, DSD 1024, which is 45,158,400 samples per second. Fast enough, isn't it? There is a possibility of 5 or 8 bits encoded DSD 128, but it's not used on SACD. And I have no information about whether it's used or not, or maybe it's only used in recording, mixing or archiving processes. These are called wide DSD, and it's possible not only for the 128, but the higher samplers can use it as well. To make it equal to the PCM, I found some arguments. 16, 20 or 24 bit, but I think we can simplify for now. The DSD64 is approximately 88.2 kHz 24 bit PCM, the DSD128 approximately 176.4 kHz 24 bit PCM, and the DSD256 approximately 352.8 kHz 24 bit PCM. On these music samples, you can see quite well the shortest track, the chill, is the biggest file, 1.7 GB, even though it's only 2.5 minutes. In DSD64, the 5-minute song is only 204 MB. This trick makes the music dynamic range as high as 120 dB, that is pretty much the human hearing limit, and the frequency response is raised between 2 and 100 kHz. While most of the people hearing cuts approximately 90 decibel and between 80 Hz to 16 kHz. So there is a time to think about whether it is meaningless or not. The DSD uses delta sigma modulation, which was described by C.C. Cutler in 1954. The first step will be the delta modulation sample taken, which describes the changes in the signal, not its absolute value. After that comes the sigma modulation, that describes the changes in voltage. So the signal's voltage become higher or lower and how much. The rate comes from the clock signal. This will be a 1-bit oversampled, but very high noise signal, because the delta modulation generates noise. At that point, the noise shaping process comes up. That means the noise are shifted towards high frequencies. And this is one of the biggest negative of this method, a high noise ratio above 25 kHz. The other negative is that it was based on 44.1 kHz. And therefore only in exact multiples of it perfectly convertible. That's another question. At what frequencies is the error, how well comes out, and can it be heard? The thing is, it's not very clear what processes it goes through, but definitely works. So back to the disc. It can include stereo mix and multi-channel up to 5.1, but it's in two separate parts on the disc. Usually the stereo at the front, and after that section 5.1 begins with a notation. After that, extra data bits may be added, like text, images, etc. On the hybrid discs, the CD layer is on the top, closer to the laser reader, because the normal CD players weren't able to focus at that time. The SACD layer, called HD layer, is at the bottom, and the 650 nanometer laser can focus on it, as in the case of the second layer of a DVD disc. On the non-hybrid dual-layer SACD disc, both layers contain sound, like a dual-layer DVD. This is the Sony DVD SACD player. The NS700 is a relatively simple device, but perhaps one of the most common SACD players. Philips and Sony produce this kind of. This Mike Oldfield disc has been around for a long time here, and I got it for free because no one wanted it. I recognized right away that's an SACD disc, so I tapped it. Maybe I will be able to play back the HD layer someday. This is a hybrid disc stereo CD layer, and on the HD layer it is stereo and the 5-1 mix can also be found. I thought, great, then I will plug in coax digital output to the amplifier and go. But no, it was all silent. After some wondering and swearing, I found out this will not work with SACD audio to digital output. And not only this, but most of the players. The only way to listen the 5.1 is to use the player's 5.1 analog output to be connected to the amp analog 5.1 input. But my amp hasn't got this. By pressing the display button, you can see in the pop-up menu how the areas are separated. By switching the multi per two channels, the laser unit has to go to the appropriate area. The stereo part there would be a separate disc, and the multi-channel part also. It is interesting that the length also differs here. Certain PS3s can play SACDs, but not all and only up to a certain firmware version. Some of them are also able to convert to DTS only to 48 kHz. There are also Blu-ray players with an SACD option. Sony, Philips, Oppo, Denon, Marantz, Dig, Yamaha are available. Maybe there are other manufacturers, but usually only the top models. SACD has copy protection, not just any kind. It has a bit modulation on it, a kind of physical copy protection, an 80-bit encryption on the sound data stream, and the key is at certain points on the disc, and checks it during the playback time to time. The HD layer cannot be played on a computer. Even FUBAR only sees the CD layer. The Power DVD and other programs do not even recognize that. I came up with the following solution with the files I was able to download. The laptop has FUBAR 2000 software with the SACD input plugin. You can set up nicely here how to play the sound. HDMI to the amplifier and sending 96 kHz 24-bit audio. This became the best experience, and even 5.1 also was sent out. A neat little software. The other software which could play for me the DSD files, the Cyberlink Power DVD. It was quite a surprise because I didn't expect it. The DSD is not a single type of file, but there are variations. The DSD stream file has the extension .dsf, the VSD, wideband single bit data version .vsd, and DSD interchange has the extension .dff. The whole SACD thing seems for me a bit problematic. I've also read it from several people on the internet that they find it very difficult to play back even DSD files as well. Sometimes there are illogical setting gaps. It loses functionality if I cannot send it to an amplifier, or you have to have all components which supports DSD by default, so it will be very expensive in the end, and it's doubtful whether it's worth it. Sony always thought in a full system, and partly because of this was able to succeed, but I have a feeling SACD was one of those times when they didn't, they behaved in ad hoc way. SACD was not a huge success, but it still exists for audiophile circles. About 6,000 discs were released in this format, but it's quite limited. Lots of jazz and soul, classical, little pop, rock and modern. We'll be right back. DSD downloads are more available, which is much simpler, and not only DSD64, but higher versions, 128, 256, and 512 also available. Larger ones are rarer. All through, SACD is neither a success nor failure. Sony found a way forward of it, because even if it's not on a disc, DSD says, thank you, I am fine. Since, like with this Tascam DA3000 converter, it became one of the master and archiving formats for studios. Thanks for watching, press like, subscribe, see you next time.